supercomputer that was a Cray XMP. Peak performance, I believe, of about 100 megaflops, which means that it could do 100 million math operations per second. So adding and subtracting and dividing numbers, which sounds absolutely amazing. Until you consider that the supercomputer we're going to see in a few minutes, Comet, has a peak performance of 2.5 petaflops. So that's 2,500 trillion math operations per second. So roughly 25 million times more powerful than our first supercomputer. So in the early days, a supercomputer was really used by researchers from the engineering and hard science disciplines. So a lot of physicists, astronomers, astrophysicists, ocean and climate modeling, computational chemistry. Over the years, the range of applications has really broadened. In fact, we find that life science researchers now account for a little more than half of the usage of our supercomputers. I'm going to be emphasizing the two supercomputers. Fordham, which is our older supercomputer, I think it's about 7 years old now, and Comet, which is our newer system. Both of these were made available through grants from the National Science Foundation, and even though they're here in our machine room on the UCSC campus, in a sense they're not really our machines, they're national resources. We allocate them to the broader research community. We have probably more than 200 universities with researchers and faculty who are using our supercomputer.